Doran militanyena tasmai shri gurave namaha. Nama om Vishnu padaya Krishna prishtaya bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti namine. Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're reading Brihad Bhagavatamrita. Last week we finished the second part, so I went back to the first part because we never read the first part. So we're going to go through the first part now, beginning the first part now. We actually began last week, so we're on the first verse where there's a long purport. So Sanatana Goswami, in the first verse, he offers his obeisances to the Supreme Lord. And in the purport, Sanatana Goswami describes that Lord Krishna enjoys his private pastimes in Goloka. So we may wonder, is it possible for conditioned souls like us, who are conditioned by the material nature, is it possible for us to ever contact him? So we should understand, it's possible. It's not impossible, but of course it takes good fortune for us to get the opportunity to hear about and to understand the special position of Lord Krishna. And this book, this Brihad Bhagavatamrita, is it's a special book, and it reveals to us about the very secret glories of Lord Krishna, which are not for the ordinary public, really, but for real devotees.
Sorry, Sati Mataji said that last week we didn't talk about the first verse. We only talked about Bhagavad Gita.
Yeah, well, the week before that we talked about this. But the week before that, of course, last week we did Bhagavad Gita, but the week before that we had begun the Brihad Bhagavatamrita.
Really?
Huh?
No.
Yes, we had. I have it marked. I have my book marked.
Sorry to interrupt you, because Saint Mary sent a message to me that last week we didn't.
Okay, last week we didn't, but 2 weeks before we did. Of course, last week we spoke about Bhagavad Gita, but the week before that we were already doing, we had already begun the first part of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita.
Oh. 上周我们没讲，就是大伯家的很难甘露。上周我们讲的是不叫放歌，但是在上上周，已经开始讲了，就是大伯家的很甘露第一部分的第一个世界，因为马拉那里已经有书签了。So
this book is going to tell us about some of the secret pastimes of Lord Krishna.
所以这本书将给我们讲述主 Krishna 秘密的小时光。
So somebody may wonder, is that really hopeless? Is it no point to do that? Is there any point? Is it really worth the while? So the author answers that doubt in this particular first verse of the book.
作者就在这部书的第一个世节就回答了这个疑惑。So
before he describes Krishna's unique qualities, he first talks about Krishna's exceptional generosity.
在谈论主 Krishna 独一无二的品质之前，他首先谈论的是主 Krishna 非同寻常的、非同凡响的慷慨大度。
So we know that Lord Krishna came from Goloka 5,000 years ago, and he appeared in the district of Mathura. And his purpose in coming, one of the purposes in coming, was to give pure love for his own lotus feet.
其中一个目的是给予他自己对他莲花族的纯洁无瑕的奉爱。By
appearing personally, Krishna gave his special mercy, made his special mercy available.
通过他亲身降临亲自的显现，他就让他的仁慈，每个人都可以得到他的仁慈。So
someone may say, and it's not wrong to say, they may say that, well, Krishna came to kill Kamsa and other evil kings. Well, of course, Krishna has unlimited energies, and they can do such small things. These are not very big things for him. He doesn't need to appear just to do that. He can do that without coming. He can do that through his energies. But his primary purpose in coming was to make available pure love of God. And he couldn't give that responsibility to somebody else. He had to do it himself. He had to come himself to do this. He couldn't ask somebody else to do it for him. Queen Kunti also brought out this point in her prayers in the first canto in the Srimad Bhagavatam.
Kunti 皇后在圣典博迦瓦坛第一篇的祈祷文当中也提到了这一点。
She said to Krishna that you come to this world to spread the science of devotional service and to give the science of devotional service.
Kunti 王后对主 Krishna 说，您来到这里，来到这个物质世界，是为了给予奉献服务的科学。
And he, Krishna especially wants to give that devotional service to advanced transcendentalists and also mental speculators.
主 Krishna 特别的特意的想把奉爱服务给予那些进步的超然主义者和心智推敲家们。
Those people who have been purified and they're able to distinguish between matter and spirit.
那些获得了净化的人们有能力区分物质与灵性。
So Queen Kunti says, how could we women ever know you perfectly?
所以昆蒂皇后说，像我们这样的妇人怎么能够完美的了解您呢？
Or you could say that Queen Kunti is saying, how can we women see you? Because you have appeared as an avatar.
换言之，昆蒂皇后说，像我们这样的妇人是如何能够看到您显现于 avatar 化身这个事实呢？
And you come to this world to make these self-realized saints to take up devotional service.
您来到这个世界是为了让那些自我觉悟的圣人们能够开始从事奉爱服务。
And you do this, Krishna does this by attracting them with his personal qualities.
主 Krishna 是透过他个人的品质吸引了他们，从实现了这一点。
So in his first verse in the book, Srila Sanatana Goswami is talking about Lord Krishna being very magnanimous.
在这部书当中的第一个世节，作者就谈到了 Krishna 特别的慷慨大度。
So now Sanatana Goswami is going to describe Krishna's characteristics and how he contributes.To distributing pure love of God.
Sanatana Goswami 描述主 Krishna 他的特点，他在传播对神手的纯粹的爱方面，他是独一无二的。
And in the second half of the first verse, it shows the sweet charm, talks about the sweet charm of Lord Krishna's pastimes.
在第一个诗节的后半部分，作者描述了主 Krishna 他的迷人的逍遥时光的甜美。
So Lord Krishna has a he's very deeply loved by all the cowherd women in Vrindavan.
主 Krishna 受到了 Vrindavan 那些牧牛女深深的挚爱。
So when Sanatana Goswami talks about this in this first verse, he's indicating to us about the meaning of the special mantra, the Gopal mantra.
在第一个诗节当中 ，Sanatana Goswami 就谈到了这首特殊的 mantra, Gopal mantra 的含义。
And that Gopal mantra is very important. We read about that in the second part of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita. Gop Kumar used to meditate, used to chant the Gopal mantra.
Gopal Kumar 常常冥想或者是唱诵这首 Gopal Mantra.
So Lord Krishna, he freely distributes the love of God to many fortunate souls. But he always has a special love for his devotees, beginning with the gopis of Vrindavan. Krishna feels affection for his devotees in response to the way in which they love him. But the gopis' love for Krishna is so pure, it's so complete and natural that nobody else's love can ever compare to it. Their love is, they don't have any motivation behind their love. They're not thinking to get something from Krishna. They're completely pure and they're not conditioned in any way. So they're more dear to Krishna than anyone else, and they always will be. So we should not doubt the position of the gopis. Lord Krishna is never, he's never indifferent to the gopis, or he's never dissatisfied with them. And great devotees like Narada Muni and other devotees, they will also tell us that in their own words, that the gopis are the greatest. That's, of course, we read all that in the second part of the book. So someone may doubt if it's actually possible to ever understand the Vrindavan gopis' love for Krishna. And as long as our mind is still affected by lust and anger and greed, then we cannot begin to appreciate the position and the purity of the gopis' love. But by the special mercy of Krishna, in his most recent appearance on earth, these problems can be overcome very easily. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not different from Lord Krishna. And he has come to show us the true nature of love of God, prema bhakti.
Krishna
So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he shows the ecstatic mood of the gopis. He shows what it is to love Krishna in the mood of the gopis. And that love which the devotee feels, that is due to the love which Krishna feels for the devotees. So this is the special contribution of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he is the only real friend of all the unhappy and degraded souls that who are in this world.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the one who is the only friend of all the unhappy and degraded souls in this world.
And he allows all of us in the present times that we can directly experience that love of Krishna and the gopis. Yeah, the gopis love Krishna and Krishna loves the gopis. As much as the gopis love Krishna, Krishna loves the gopis equally. The same, he gives back the love which they give to him. And if we understand the gopis' pure love, then we can understand the position of Krishna. So in this way, Sanatana Goswami is outlining the theme of the book, this book.
Sanatana Goswami 以这种方式就勾勒出了这部书的主线。
So the first part of this book is going to tell us about what the Lord's mercy, where Krishna's mercy actually resides. The conclusion is that the gopis are his most beloved devotees. And their love for him is the highest achievement of life. And Sanatana Goswami, who has written this book, he has personally experienced this. So it's not difficult for him to describe it for us. We should not doubt that he's going to tell us the nature of this very confidential pastimes of Krishna. So we're encouraged to hear this book with confidence, with full confidence. Alright, so we'll go on to the second verse. So Sanatana Goswami writes in the second verse, All glories to all of the gopis, headed by Radhika, Sri Radhika.
The second verse is 所有荣耀都归于以虚拉伊克为首的 Gopi 们，牧牛姑娘们。
The Gopis are famous as Krishna's dearmost devotees.
Gopi 们以主 Krishna 最亲爱的奉献者而闻名遐迩。
We cannot begin to even describe how the love which they have for Lord Hari, Sri Hari Krishna.
We 甚至都无法来开始描述他们对 Sri Hari 的爱。
So we get the favor of Krishna by pleasing his dearmost devotees. If we want to get Krishna's mercy, we have to please his devotees. So this verse is describing the position of the gopis of Vrindavan. And we know Sri Radhika, or Srimati Radharani, she is the best of all the gopis. So that's why her name is mentioned first. So although Krishna may sometimes lose interest in other devotees, or become dissatisfied with them, he never loses interest in the gopis.
尽管至尊主有的时候会对其他的奉献者，失去兴趣，或者是对其他的奉献者感到不满意，但他从来不会对 gopi 们漠不关心、不感兴趣。
Yeah, all the pure devotees.They agree that the gopis' love for Krishna is the highest. And Lord Krishna himself told the gopis, he told them, he said, I'm not able to repay you for all that you've done for me.
So Krishna 亲口告诉 gopi 们，我无法偿还你们对我所做的爱，所做的服务和爱。
Lord Krishna said, even within a life of Brahma, even if I'm here for a life of Brahma, I won't be able to repay you for all that you've done.
主 Krishna 说，即便我在这里停留如 Brahma 的一生那么长的寿命，也无法偿还对你们的债务。
Lord Krishna said, you give up all your connections with the family and with your relatives and you, society, you gave up everything just for me.
Krishna 说，你们放弃了你们的家人，放弃了社会，只是为了我。
And these things are very difficult to give up, but you did it.
而这些是非常难以放弃的。但是你们却做到了。
So you have to be satisfied with your own glorious deeds.
你们要一定要因为你们自己光荣的行为而感到心满意足。
Just like devotees, they go for sankirtan and book distribution. And how can we ever thank them for what they're doing?They're doing so much, they're accepting so much difficulties on behalf of Krishna.
正像奉献者们上街从事Sankirtan派出的服务，我们怎么能够来完全的感激他们对为 Krishna 做的所有这些艰难困苦的服务呢？
We cannot repay them, but they have to just simply be satisfied themselves that they've done.The highest service for Krishna.
我们无法偿还他们，他们只能为他们自己为 Krishna 所做的这份崇高的服务而感到心满意足。
So the gopis are famous as the best devotees of Krishna.
那些 gopi 们 Krishna 最优秀的奉献者而闻名遐迩。
And it's very clear that Lord Krishna considers, he gives the deepest affection for them.
显而易见的，就 Krishna 对 Gopi 给予 Gopi 们是最深厚的爱意。
So the position of their devotion is beyond, there's no need to prove their devotion. It's already confirmed. Everybody agrees. We don't need to analyze it anymore.
So, we don't need to prove this, or to make further analysis. This is already obvious.
But Sanatana Goswami mentions here that no one can describe even a small, even a particle of their love which they have for Krishna.
Srila Sanatana Goswami 在这里提到说，没有人甚至能够描述他们对 Krishna 的爱的原子般的这份爱，能够描述哪怕是。
Yeah, the gopis' love for Krishna is so wonderful that Krishna himself cannot describe it.
Gopi 们对 Krishna 的爱是如此的奇妙，连 Krishna 本人也无法描述。
So the Lord Krishna understood that the ecstasy which the gopis andthese great devotees, the ecstasy which they feel in loving him, it's sweeter than the ecstasy which he gets out of loving them.
So Krishna 意识到他的那些挚爱的奉献者们在对他的爱当中感受到的这狂喜甚至比他自己比他自己感受到的这狂喜更加甜美。
So that's why Krishna came to this world in the form of a devotee.
正是由于这个原因，就 Krishna 亲自降临到这个世界，就以他自己的奉献者的形象降临。
And he took on the dress, he dressed himself as a renunciate, and he was golden in effulgence.
他的着装是一个弃绝者的着装，托钵僧的着装，而他的肤色是金黄的。
And of course, his name is Sri Krishna Chaitanya, the son of Mother Sachi.
他的名字是 Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Sachi 妈妈的儿子。
Sorry, just a minute. I have a little bit.Mucus here. Okay, so the doubts raised in the first two verses might again be raised here.
在头两个诗节当中，人们产生的疑惑在这里可能会再次被提起。
How can you ever describe this love? Because it's so high.So Sanatana Goswami explains that Lord Chaitanya is the person to deliver the most fallen souls.
Srila Sanatana Goswami 回答说 Sri Chaitanya 是堕落灵魂的拯救者。
Lord Chaitanya is descended in his most attractive form to distribute the taste of Sankirtan.
Sri Chaitanya 以他最迷人的形象降临来派发 Sankirtan 的滋味。
By chanting the holy names of the Lord, So,Lord Chaitanya came to establish that process, the chanting of the holy names. Of course, that's a yuga dharma.
Sri Chaitanya, 他前来确立了 yuga dharma 年代宗教，就是唱诵他的圣名。
So Lord, Sanatana Goswami wants the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, so he glorifies Lord Chaitanya.
Srila Sanatana Goswami 希望获得主 Chaitanya 的仁慈，因此就在这个世界荣耀了他。
So greater than Krishna's love for his devotees is the love his devotees feel for him.
比主 Krishna 对他的奉献者的爱更加伟大的是他亲密的奉献者对主 Krishna 的爱。
So Krishna noted that, and he wants to taste that sweetness which they are getting in loving him.
主 Krishna 注意到了这点，所以他就希望能够品尝到。
And that's why Krishna came. It was why he took this form of his own devotee.
正是由于这个原因，他就化身为他自己的奉献者的形象。
So Lord Krishna came to this earth. He came in the province of Godadesh, the city of Navadvipas the son of Sachi.
因此 Chaitanya 降临到了 Godadesh 这个地区，降临到了 Navadvip， 投生为 Sachi Deva 的儿子。
And as Lord Chaitanya, he has the most beautiful golden form. Although he's Lord Krishna, he's taken a golden form and he's very beautiful.
尽管如柴丹尼亚是 Krishna 本人，他却以龙金的肤色来显现，而且他的相貌俊美。
So Lord Chaitanya was actually present around the time this book was being written.
在这部书成书的时代，如柴丹尼亚仍然在世。
And Sanatana Goswami, he had the opportunity to personally associate with Lord Chaitanya.
这部书的作者 Sanatana Goswami 有机会得到跟主的亲身联谊的机会。
So Lord Chaitanya experiences what Krishna was unable to describe about the love of the gopis.
如柴丹尼亚可以亲身体验到 Krishna 无法描述勾皮的爱的，他可以体验到这一点。
Lord Chaitanya not only experiences it, he reveals it, he shows it to his followers.
如柴丹尼亚不仅亲身体验到了这一点，他还向他的追随者们揭示了这份体验。
So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the supreme personality of Godhead.
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是至尊，性格神圣。
And Lord Chaitanya has a very great regard for his devotees. He loves them more than he loves himself.
Krishna Chaitanya 爱他的奉献者甚过他爱自己。
Lord Chaitanya would say that by taking the dust of the feet of the devotees, I can purify the material world.
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 说，通过来拾取奉献者的莲花族的尘土，我就渴望来净化整个食物的世界。
Lord Chaitanya said, I always follow in the footsteps of the pure devotees. They're always peaceful and free from all personal desires. They're always remembering the pastimes of Krishna. And they don't have bad feelings to anyone.
They don't have bad feelings to anyone.
So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he would think like this.
主陈丹娘马哈帕布就是这样的思维。
And so Lord Krishna came as Lord Chaitanya, and that way he is in the form of his own devotee.
So Krishna 以陈丹娘的身份来降临，因此他的形象是一个奉献者的形象。
But there's also another meaning to this. We can understand this fact in another way. We should understand that when Krishna comes from his eternal abode, from Goloka, as Lord Chaitanya, at that time, one of his companions that he comes with Lord Chaitanya, that his companion comes and his companion is born as the son of Kumar. And he's in an old Brahmana family.
那我们也可以另外一种方式来理解。当主 Krishna 以主 Chaitanya 的身份从永恒的国度降临的时候，他带来了一个同游，他降生为，一个古老的婆罗门家庭的，是库玛的儿子。
And this devotee, he is born as a son. He's born in a Brahmana family, and he's born in South India.
这个人降生于婆罗门家庭。降生为南印度。
And this is actually Rupa Goswami, who is the brother of Sanatana Goswami.
这实际上是 Rupa Goswami, 是 Sanatana Goswami 的弟弟。
But so when he writes Bhakta Rupa, it can mean either Rupa Goswami, his brother, or it can mean also Lord Chaitanya. Because Lord Chaitanya takes the form of a devotee.
所以当作者使用了 Bhakta Rupena 这个词的时候，他或者是指他的弟弟 Rupa Goswami， 或者是指主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu。
So when Lord Chaitanya is in the form of a sannyasi, he gives out he distributes the method of devoting. He shows everyone how to devote themselves to Krishna.
当主 Chaitanya 降临的时候，他展示了如何对他做出父爱的方法。
Yeah, he shows people how to chant the holy name of Krishna and how to worship Krishna and offer prayers to Krishna.
他向世人展示如何唱诵主的圣名，如何主卖 Krishna， 如何向 Krishna 做出祈祷。
So by these activities, things which are not usually possible to know, they can be revealed. For the benefit of those people who live in the fallen material world, they learn how they can awaken their consciousness and bring it to the higher platform.
为了那些物质世界的堕落的人们的好处，他们就可以学习到如何唤醒更高层面的知觉。
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he has described Lord Chaitanya's mercy to the world.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 向世界描述了主 Chaitanya 的仁慈。
Yeah, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. He was a great scholar, and he wrote this very nice poem about Lord Chaitanya.
He said, Sarvabhauma.
Let my consciousness, which is like a honey bee, take shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna. He has just now appeared in this world. Although Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come in this world to teach the ancient system of devotional service. He's teaching us how to do devotional service for the pleasure of Krishna in whatever form we want. We could worship him and maybe we can worship him in the two-armed form, or you may worship him some other form. You may worship him as Krishna, you may worship him as Lord Chaitanya. So, Lord Chaitanya has come to teach us this system which had almost been lost due to the influence of time. So we heard Sanatana Goswami offer his prayers to Krishna, and then he offered his prayers to the gopis, and then he offered his prayers to Lord Chaitanya. So now in the fourth verse, Sanatana Goswami offers his prayers to the goddess Mathura Devi, the best of holy cities. So Mathura Devi enchants the mind, and she's very dear to the enemy of Kamsa.
Mathura Devi 令人们的心意感到, 吸引了人们的心意, 她对于Kamsa的敌人是最为亲切的。
And one of the beautiful places in Mathura is the place where Lord Krishna made his appearance. The birthplace of Lord Krishna makes Mathura even more beautiful. So the city of Mathura is famous all over the world because it helps us to get rid of misery. And it also can give us devotion and liberation. And we should remember that many different pastimes of Lord Krishna were also performed there in Mathura. So Lord Krishna has great love for the holy land of Mathura. Because many of his favorite pastimes, his eternal pastimes, took place there.
Because
And the whole district of Mathura, the whole district of Mathura is therefore one place in the material world where one can perfect all his human efforts.
正是由于这个原因，马图拉这块区域是在物质宇宙当中一个人可以他的人生的努力能够达到完美的这样一个地方。
So to get the favor of Mathura, Sanatana Goswami is offering this prayer to glorify Mathura.
为了获得是 Mathura 的仁慈，Sanatana Goswami 就用这个世界荣耀赞美了 Mathura Devi.
Yeah, when we say Devi, Devi means one who is a goddess or one who is perpetually effulgent.
当我们说到 Devi 这个词，意思是一位女神，意思是一位拥有永恒光灿的女神。
So because Mathura has Lord Krishna always present within her borders, so she's not afraid of anything.
由于拥有至尊主 Krishna 在自己的疆土之内，所以 Mathura 再不用害怕任何的事物了。
So she has no fear about time and any other causes of destruction. They cannot trouble Mathura Devi.
所以她并不恐惧时间因素，也不并不害怕其他的毁灭原因。
So there are seven principal holy cities, and Mathura is the best of them.
在所有圣城当中，有七座主要圣城，而 Mathura 是首当其冲的。
One place is Kasi, which is Banaras.
一座圣城是 Kasi, Banaras.
And then Kanchi. Kanchi is in South India.
另一座是南印度的 Kanchi.
Then Avanti. Now today it's called Ujjain, but before it was called Avanti.
第三座圣城是 Avanti, 也就是现今的 Ujjain 城。
And then Ayodhya, the place of Lord Rama.
下一座是主 Rama 的地方 Ayodhya.
And then Hardwar, or it's also called Mayapuri, Hardwar. It's on the bank of the Ganges in North India.
下一座被称为是 Haridwar, 在北印度的一个城市，也被称为 Mayapuri.
Yeah, it's at the foothill of the Himalayas, Haridwar.
它坐落在喜马拉雅山路的脚下。
And then Dwarka is another holy city that is Lord Krishna's home over very in the far.West of India on the coast, Dwarka.
下一座是印度西海岸边上的 Krishna 自己的地方 Dwarka.
And Mathura, of course.
当然还有 Mathura.
So these seven holy cities, they can each give liberation.
这七座圣城，每一座城市都能单独的赐予解脱。
But Mathura is better than all the other cities throughout the universe.
但是 Mathura 城比整个宇宙当中所有的城市都更加荣耀。
Doesn't matter if they belong to humans or demigods or incarnations of God, Mathura is the best.
无论这些城市属于人也好，或是属于其他神兽的化身也好， 其中 Mathura 是最好的佼佼者。
And Mathura pleases the mind of anyone who comes in contact with her.
Mathura 能够取悦任何一个能跟她产生接触的人的心意。
She can satisfy all desires.
她能够满足所有的人的内心的欲望。
Yeah, there's a verse in the scriptures which says, if people have material desires,Mathura will give the three aims of human work. The three aims are religion, economic development, and sense gratification.
有一节诗就说到，对于那些拥有物质欲望的人们，马祖罗可以实现他们的人生的三个目标，以及宗教、经济发展和感官享乐。
And if somebody wants to get liberation, then Mathura can also give liberation.
倘若有人希望得到解脱， Mathura 也可以赐予他们解脱。
And Mathura can also give pure devotion.
Mathura 甚至能够赐予纯粹的奉爱。
So, we should, if anybody is, if you have any intelligence at all, you'll want to go and take shelter.Of Mathura.
所以如果您有一丝一毫的智慧的话，就希望能够托庇于 Mathura.
Mathura is very dear to Lord Krishna.
Mathura 对主 Krishna 至为亲切。
And Mathura got Krishna's special favor after Krishna killed Kamsa, because Kamsa was staying in Mathura.
在主 Krishna 杀死了邪恶的康萨王之后， Mathura 城对 Krishna 更为亲切，因为康萨王原来就在 Mathura。
And even though Kamsa was ruling Mathura, the people of Mathura they hardly ever felt any fear or distress.
即便是在康萨王统治 Mathura 的时候，马祖勒城内的人们也没有一丝一毫的恐惧焦虑。
And Krishna's greatest favor to Mathura was that he took birth there and lived there with his parents.
主 Krishna 对于马祖勒最了不起的恩宠就是他在这种城诞生，并且和他的父母居住在那里。
So, we see Lord Krishna is eternally present in Mathura.
我们说主 Krishna 永恒的就在 Mathura 这个地方。
Because Mathura has Krishna's birthplace and Krishna's residence, and Mathura gets rid of all inauspiciousness.
因为 Mathura 它拥有主 Krishna 的降生地和主 Krishna 的居所，它也能驱散一切的不吉祥。
And it gives us liberation and it gives us pure devotion.
它能够帮助给予我们解脱，以及给予我们奉爱。
So that's why Mathura is glorified throughout the world.
由于这个原因， Mathura 在全世界得到了荣耀。
And Mathura district is where Lord Krishna exhibited his Rasa Lila pastimes and his other intimate pastimes.
并且马杜勒区域，他展示了主奎什纳的拉萨之舞的消时光，以及其他亲密的消时光。
So very difficult to describe these things.
所以这些事情是很难以描述的。
Okay, so we will stop here today.
好，我们今天就讲到这里。
We'll go on tomorrow, next week.
我们下一周继续。
Are there any questions?
Not yet. 请问大家有问题吗？现在可以提问题。 Yes, here's a question from Ina. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and dear devotees, please accept my obeisances of glory to Srila Prabhupada. Guru Maharaj, in one of your lectures, you said that it is very important to have the right mood when visiting a holy place. What does it mean to be in the right mood?
The right mood?
In the Manasita Vintage, Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 亲爱的奉献者，我谦卑的顶拜您，荣耀归于师父。Guru Maharaj, 在您的一堂讲课当中，您说到了，在朝拜圣地的时候，拥有正确的心态这一点至关重要。那么，什么叫做在正确的心态当中呢？
Well, the right mood means that you don't just come to the holy place to do shopping or to sightsee.
To
shopping or what? To do shopping or to go sightseeing.
正确的心态就是说我们来朝拜圣地不是为了来购物或者是去旅游观光。
Come to the holy place to get purification. And we get purification by hearing from devotees.
我们前来圣地是为了获得净化，通过聆听奉献者来获得净化。
So coming to the holy place, we don't come here just to get sense gratification. And you have to be willing to accept sometimes a little bit austerity, a little difficulty. You leave your comfortable home and you come to live in the holy place. So you don't have your own residence, and maybe the food is also different from what you're used to.
您离开了自己舒适的家，来居住在圣地。在圣地呢，你可能没有自己的住所，吃的食物也跟家里吃的不一样。
But that's not important. When we come to the holy place, we don't mind a little difficulty.
但是这一点并不重要。当我们来圣地的时候呢，所有上述的并不，我们不会在意的。
We come to the holy place to get purified.
我们来到圣地是为了得到净化。
And the purification comes by hearing from the pure devotees.
这份净化来自于聆听纯粹奉献者。
Okay, is there any other question?
Yes. 下一个问题是 Chaitanya Charan Prabhu, Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Gurudev. 在梵歌1-6章 Krishna 讲了瑜伽阶梯，里面哪些知识是属于 Jnana Yoga? In chapter 1-6 of Bhagavad Gita,Lord Krishna related about the ladder, the yoga ladder. Which knowledge belong to the category of Jnana Yoga?
Well, all the knowledge, it's all part of Jnana Yoga. The knowledge about the difference between the body and the soul in the second chapter, Krishna's talking aboutthe nature of the soul and the difference from the body that's there. So that's Jnana Yoga.
所有的知识都属于 Jnana Yoga. 在第二章当中涉及到了灵魂躯体之间的区别，讲到了灵魂的本性，这就属于 Jnana Yoga.
And then in the fourth chapter, Lord Krishna describes about his appearance and his purpose in coming to this world, and the nature of his transcendental form.
而到了第四章，Krishna开始描述他显现于这个物质世界的目的，他超然形体的本性。
And then we also hear at the end of the fourth chapter, Lord Krishna describes about how we can get transcendental knowledge, that we have to approach the spiritual teacher, and we have to inquire from him. And then in the third chapter, we hear Arjuna ask Krishna a question about why do we do sinful things unwilling, and Lord Krishna explains about lust and how we can conquer lust and where you can find lust. So Lord Krishna is giving a lot of knowledge.
Okay. Yeah. So, Hare Krishna, based on Guru teachers. So, now I'm doing a writing story about to glorify devotees. So I want Guru to get some instruction from Guru and some blessing from Guru. Now I'm doing writing stories to glorify devotees. I found that every devotee who's on the path of bhakti have many moving stories. On the one hand, they stick to the teaching of Bhagavad Gita, and they follow very strictly and firmly the footsteps of Guru and Sadhu. On the other hand, they have great courage to break through those regular false concept in daily life. Indeed, they are the group that truly need to be warmed and truly need to be cared about. Guru, how can we do this program? To this program to encourage devotee and to attract more person into devotional life. Now we are doing this program about the glory of devotees.
Well, mainly we want to teach about devotional service.
要点就是我们希望来教导奉爱服务。
We want to teach people about Lord Krishna, of course, and Lord Krishna's pure devotees.
我们希望教导人们有关于主 Krishna 和有关于主 Krishna 的纯粹奉献者。
And Srila Prabhupada would say, devotees, that there are many pure devotees. All the devotees are pure devotees.
Srila Prabhupada 以前说过，有许多的纯粹奉献者，实际上所有的奉献者都是纯粹奉献者。
So it's nice you want to glorify the devotees. It's very nice you like to tell some things about devotees' experiences, and this way maybe people will also appreciate devotees.
所以您做这档荣耀奉献者的节目很好，因为它讲述了奉献者的经历，也许人们就能通过这档节目来被奉爱所吸引，来欣赏奉献者。
Of course, you will always get some people who have negative opinions. They have maybe a bad experience even sometimes, you know.
当然呢，你可能也会遇到那些有负面想法的人们，他们内心还存有不良的情绪。
It's very difficult to please everyone and to care for everyone.
要想取悦每个人，要想关怀每个人是非常难的。
As we say, you know, people mean problems, and the more people you have, the more problems there are.
有这么一句话是说，人群就意味着问题，人群的数量，人的数量越多，就意味着有更多的问题。
So it's very, your thinking is very nice that you want to glorify the devotees.
您的想法非常好，您希望能够荣耀奉献者们。
You hope that by glorifying devotees, you can bring people to Krishna consciousness.
您希望透过荣耀奉献者，能够把人们带到 Krishna 世界当中。
We understand that Krishna consciousness is in everyone's heart.
我们要明白Krishna 知觉在每个生物体内心。
So we try to bring people into Krishna consciousness by getting them attracted to Krishna.
我们希望能够让人们受到 Krishna 吸引，从而进入到 Krishna 知觉。
Sometimes people become attracted to one devotee, and then if that devotee goes away or goes somewhere else, then they feel, oh, I've lost my friend. I don't want to be a devotee anymore because my friend is not there.
也有这种情况，就是某个人他受到一位奉献者的吸引，从而加入。但是如果这位奉献者离开了或者去了别的地方，那么这个人就会心里想，哦，我的朋友已经走了。
So they become discouraged and may give up devotional service.
在这种情况下，他们就会感到气馁、沮丧，放弃公安服务。
So it's important to get people fixed towards Krishna.To know Krishna. Krishna's God. And Prabhupada is the boss.
So, it's important to let people, let people,
So he's like the boss of the Krishna consciousness movement.
所以Srila Prabhupada他是奠基创办灵性导师Vanacharya，他是Krishna知觉运动的大老板。
We like to glorify Krishna and Prabhupada. And if people get attracted to Krishna and Prabhupada, then that is very good. That is very, very helpful for their Krishna consciousness.
倘若人们能够受到 Krishna 和 Prabhupada 的吸引，这样是非常好的。这个对于他们的 Krishna 直觉是非常非常有帮助的。
So try to do everything in relation to Krishna and Prabhupada.
所以请您努力的，就是让您的所有的活动都和是 Krishna 有关，和是的 Prabhupada 有关。
What makes someone a good devotee?
我，sorry。What
is it that makes someone into a good devotee? Why is someone recognized as a good devotee?
Okay.
They must be highly, very strongly attached to serving Prabhupada and Krishna. So when you glorify the devotee, you should understand, you should glorify them in that way, that their devotion to Krishna and Prabhupada.
所以您要是荣耀奉献者的时候呢，就专注于 就是荣耀于他们对于主 Krishna 的奉爱之情，以及他们对 Srila Prabhupada 内心的奉爱之情。That
is the proper way to glorify a devotee.
这个是荣耀一位奉献者的正确的方式方法。And
then from the very beginning, encourage people that you should follow that example.
所以从一开始以这种方式鼓励人们来追随这样的榜样。Yeah.
We hear about good devotees and we should think, oh, I should also do like that.
我们听到了有关于优秀奉献者的事迹，我们应该产生这样的想法，哦，我也想像他们那样做事情。
We don't want to take the place of Krishna. We don't want to take Prabhupada's place. We want to bring people to take shelter of Prabhupada and Krishna.
我们可不想代替 Krishna， 我们不想取代 Prabhupada 的地位，我们希望能够把人们带来脱离 Prabhupada， 脱离 Krishna。
And one time a devotee wrote to Prabhupada, and the devotee described, oh Prabhupada, I feel so much love for you. And Prabhupada said to them, he said, don't love me, love Krishna. Prabhupada said, at the time of death, I cannot be with you, but Krishna will be with you, and he will take you back to God.
有一次，有一位奉献者就写信给Srila Prabhupada来描述，说：“哎呦，Srila Prabhupada，我特别爱您。”但是Srila Prabhupada的回信说道：“不要爱我，你要爱Krishna。在死亡的时候，不是我和你在一起，是会 Krishna 和您在一起，是 Krishna 把你带回神手。”
Yes. Okay.
下一个问题，维达巴提，对不对？ Vedvati, in Bagurde, Timan, Dopi, then young Liji, Timan Guru, then young Liji, Krishna, who is young in the Huying Gopiman the Ain. How to understand that Krishna will reciprocate with Gopi's love?
Well, Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, he said, as you surrender to me, I reward you accordingly.
So Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》有一个师姐说，我依据一个人对我的臣服程度，我给予他们相应的回报。
Even in material life, we see this kind of reciprocation between people.
即便是在物质生活当中，我们看到两个人之间的这一种交流。
Somebody loves you, you will also have love for them. You think, oh, very nice, they love me, I will, why not, I will also love them.
你会看到，假如有人爱你的话，你会反过来爱他们，心里想，哦，真太好了，他们爱我，我也爱他们。
And someone else, they don't have that feeling of love, they don't have the loving feeling for you, then you think, why I should love them? They don't love me.
那另外一方面，倘若别的人内心并没有这份感情，你会想，哦，为什么我要爱他呢？他也并对我没有感情。
So the gopis,they just had so much love for Krishna. They loved him more than anything else.
So, gopis 们对爱 Krishna 胜过爱任何其他的人。
You have to understand, these gopis grew up in the village in Vrindavan, and they were seeing Krishna as a young boy do these wonderful pastimes.
你要明白，勾皮们是生在文达文的村子长大的，他们就看着 Krishna 就是年轻的，作为一个年轻的男孩，从事着许多的奇妙的消时光。
They saw Krishna kill Aga, Putana first of all came there. Putana came there with poison on her breast, and Krishna killed her.As a little baby, Krishna did that. And then the other demons like Trinavarta and Sakatasura. So there were so many incidents. And then Krishna's growing up and they were going to the forest and Krishna was killing demons in the forest. Different demons would come to try to trouble them in the forest and Krishna would kill them. And they'd come home at night and the cowherd boys would tell, well, today Krishna killed this big demon, Krishna killed him. And so the devotees were hearing about Krishna and they were hearing how the wonderful things he was doing. So naturally the young girls, they're attracted to a man who can do wonderful things.They appreciate, wow, Krishna is so amazing, he's so wonderful, that all the gopis were just mad in love with him.
Krishna 从小的时候，他还是小婴儿的时候，他就杀死了女巫 Putana。他把毒药涂在乳房上，想要毒死 Krishna， 却被 Krishna 所杀。Krishna 随后又杀死了恶魔 Aga, Trinavarta。还有 Sakatasura 这些事件，然后 Krishna 呢长大了一点，他又进入到森林，然后他杀森林当中杀死了很多去那里捣乱的恶魔。到晚上的时候 ，Krishna 到晚上的时候，他会从森林回家，然后那些小男孩呢就纷纷的来诉说 Krishna 白天在森林里杀恶魔的这些壮举。这些奉献者们，他们就聆听到了 Krishna 这些事迹。作为小姑娘，这些勾皮们又深深地被一个能够从事这么多奇妙的英雄壮举的一个男孩子所吸引，他们感到非常的惊讶。所以他们 就深爱着 Krishna。
Yes, young girls are attracted to young boys naturally, and if they see the young boy perform many wonderful activities, then they will be more attracted to the young man.
年轻男女之间本来就有着这种吸引力，倘若这年轻姑娘听说了这个年轻男子的这些奇妙活动，就更加受到他的吸引了。
So the all the gopis, they were just mad in love with Krishna.
所有的 gopis 们都因为爱 Krishna 都爱疯了。
Okay.
下一个是 Yukita Sharma, Yukita Sharma, Hare Krishna Gurudev, please accept humble obeisances, obeisances to all the devotees, Gurudev.I have begun talking to Lalita Sakhi and then remembered we are Das Anudas, Anudas, so approached Jiva Goswami. This question was related to dressing their lordships, lordship in the morning. This question was related to dressing the deity in the morning. And reply,Him.
What was the question?
The question is that the gopi also know that we may approach them and can hear our heartfelt prayers. The question is that can the gopis know that.Know that we are approaching them through our heartful prayer. Can we approach Gopi?
With what? A prayer?
If the question that as ordinary devotee, can we approach directly to the Gopi above the Goswamis?Yes, Lalita, that the gopi beside Radha Krishna, Lalita. Sorry.
Yes.
Let me translate first. You can. 他的问题是，因有一个上面的问题是说，就是 Gurudev。就是我开始就跟那个拉提的 Saki 就是 Radharani Krishna 旁边的这一位Gopi来说话，然后我就想起了我们本来是仆人的仆人的仆人，所以这个问题就是在早上给他们穿衣服的有关系，就我们可不可以直接接近Lalita Saki 这样的 Gopi 呢？因为我们本来应该是仆人的仆人的仆人。Maharaj's
回答是说可以。 Srimati Radharani is a gopi and she's the best of the gopis. So usually when we pray to the gopis, we pray to Srimati Radharani because she's the principal of all the gopis. She's the very best of all the gopis.
就是我们可以直接去向最优秀的 gopi 就是 Radharani 来祈祷，因为她是最好的。
And the people of Vrindavan all pray to Radharani like that. They all pray to her that please bring us to Krishna. If Radharani will accept us, then certainly Krishna will accept us.
Vrindavan 的居民们，他们都向 Radharani 祈祷，请带把我带到 Krishna 那里。所以，如果 Radharani 接受了 ，Krishna 也会接受我们。
So pray to Radharani. You don't need to pray. Of course, you pray to Srimati Radharani, then all the other gopis will also be pleased.
所以如果你想向高比牧牛姑娘祈祷，那就向 Radharani 祈祷吧，因为如果 Radharani 满意的话，别的高比也满意了。 下一个是 Vrindavan Das Hare Krishna the my Gurudev 所有奉献者莲花所，请问我们被主 Chaitanya 所吸引回灵异世界，在 Goloka 吗？在灵异世界继续唱诵主的圣名吗？ If we are attracted to Lord Chaitanya and we go back to the spiritual world, are we going to back to Goloka Vrindavan Goloka and are we going to continue chanting the Lord?
Well, Lord Chaitanya has also a place. He has Mayapur. There's a place, Mayapur, in the spiritual world. And they have Sankirtan there. So you can also, if you're very attracted to Sankirtan, you can join Lord Chaitanya.In the Sankirtan, in Mayapur, in the spiritual world. It will depend on your particular mood in worshipping Lord Chaitanya.
这也取决于您在崇拜主柴坦亚的时候内心的特殊的心绪。
Lord Chaitanya's eternal Leela is here in Mayapur Dham with all of the devotees performing Sankirtan.
主柴坦亚永恒的逍遥时光是在马普 Dham 圣地马普这里上演的，他跟所有的奉献者在这里上演 Sankirtan 的逍遥时光。
But at the same time, Lord Chaitanya sent his main disciples to Vrindavan to establish temples there in Vrindavan.
与此同时，主柴坦亚也派遣他主要的门徒去 Vrindavan 建庙。
He didn't tell them, we don't hear that he told anybody to build temples in Mayapur, but we heard that from other people, from Bhaktivinoda.
就是主柴坦亚他并没有命令他的直接的门徒去马普建庙，但是我们听到了巴迪卡库他在马普建了一所庙。
So when you worship Lord Chaitanya, you could go to Goloka also, you could be in Vrindavan, of course the mood in Vrindavan.Is not really any different from Goloka. The gopis also chant, they also do Sankirtan.
There are always some devotees who give trouble to me, disturb me, that so that my mind is not very attentive. Is that devotee are testing whether I'm doing attentive devotional service, or what's the reason? Thank you. So how, another part of the question is that how can we be not disturbed?
Well, you know, you may feel that people are disturbing you. It may just be your mind. The devotees may not be purposely doing things, but you may feel it's a disturbance. The problem really is your own mind.
您可能是您觉得感觉受到打扰了，但是这个是您的心意的问题，并不是奉献者有意的来打扰您，只是您因为您自己感到受到打扰，所以问题是来自于心意。
We have to develop tolerance also. It's a very important quality to be tolerant.
我们需要发展容忍这项重要的品质。
We get disturbed sometimes. Little things, you know. Sometimes it may simply be very insignificant to everybody else, but you're finding it a big disturbance.So the problem is probably more with you than with anybody else. That you're getting disturbed. That you're not being very tolerant.
那么就是我们可能是受到一些小事情来打扰，在别人眼里呢，这些事情是微不足道、不足挂齿的。但是您自己就感觉到很受到打扰，所以这个问题是来自于您本人。并不是出自于别人，所以您需要培养容忍、忍耐的品质。
So it's really important for us to take shelter of the holy name of Lord Krishna.
所以，更关键的是我们要托庇于主 Krishna 的圣名。
If our mind is fixed in hearing the holy name and in chanting, then you won't get disturbed by other people.
好，让我们的心意专注于聆听圣名，专注于念诵圣名，就不会受到别人的打扰的。
Yeah, so you have to maybe do more intense chanting. When these situations come, you just...Take more shelter of the holy name and chant louder.
So, you need to do the just, strongly the 念诵，就是念诵的程度要更加强烈。当这种情况出现的时候，您就要托庇于圣名，要高声的念诵圣名。
The chanting the holy name is meant to help us to be peaceful.And we shouldn't get disturbed by other people.
唱诵圣名是为了帮助我们内心平和，所以您不应当受到别人的打扰。
But you can always go another place. You can always move. If somebody is disturbing you, you just go find some other place to go and sit and chant.
但是您可以到别的地方，倘若您在一个地方觉得受打扰，您可以换一个地方，坐在那个地方，坐那儿念诵。
Sometimes you close your eyes so you don't have to see what's going on around you.
您可以闭上眼睛，就是不看你周围发生的事情。
But you really want to fix your mind on the chanting of the holy name.
但是您是就是真正要做的事情就是将心意专注于唱诵圣名这件事情。
It's a holy name which will help you to overcome these things. Because this is your problem is with the material world. You're getting disturbed by the material energy.So you have to come to the transcendental platform. And the way to do it is by chanting the holy name.
唱诵圣名就可以帮助到您克服这种问题。问题就在于在物质世界您受到了物质能量的打扰。所以您应当来到超然层面，通过唱诵圣名达到超然层面。
Or if you can take shelter of a senior devotee, that will also help you.
或者是您通过托庇一位年长的奉献者，也能够帮助到您。
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. 下一个是。 Vedavati, Varadashvara Devadasi. 明白古尔代灵阿祖什么是超然的知识？
什么是超然的知识？ Well, the fourth chapter of Bhagavad Gita is 超然的知识， right?
博伽梵歌第四章是超然的知识。
Transcendental knowledge means knowledge in relation to Krishna and Krishna's energies and Krishna's incarnations.
超然的知识是和 Krishna 有关系的知识，是和 Krishna 的能量，和 Krishna 本人有关系的知识。Krishna 的能量。
So transcendental knowledge is, what we want to hear. When we read Prabhupada's books, we get a lot of transcendental knowledge.
超然的知识是。就是我们希望聆听到的，当我们阅读《Srila Prabhupada 的书籍的时候，就能获得超然知识。
Srimad Bhagavatam is all transcendental knowledge.
圣典《博伽瓦坛》充满了超然知识。
Reading the scriptures and hearing the philosophy of Krishna consciousness.Is all transcendental knowledge.
读经典，聆听 Krishna 之觉的哲学，全属于超然知识。
Yes.
下一个问题是Hare Krishna， 哈里，礼拜咕噜，主持人，所有拜师那瓦莲花族，我的问题是，我知道吃酱油影响知觉，但是控制不住。我会单独给 Krishna 供奉没有酱油醋的，然后自己单独加，请问姑这样可以吗？真的会影响知觉吗？ I know that the soybean juices will disturb my consciousness, but still I cannot control my senses. I will offer food that is without soybean juice, and then after offering, I'll add soybean juice.So Guru, is that all right for me to do that? Will it also really affect my consciousness?
Well, Krishna is not very fond of soybean sauce.
Krishna 不是特别喜欢酱油。
What is it? Soybean? 酱油?
Yeah.
It's not the...best of food to take for giving, but whatever you take, you should offer to Krishna. If you're going to take that soybean sauce, you should offer it to Krishna. If it's in your home, at least in your own home, you can offer these things. And of course, Krishna, you can offer it separately, put it on a side dish. Don't put it on top of the noodles, and then Krishna can decide for himself if he wants to taste it or not.
Sorry, I may not translate completely, but this devotee said that he or she will offer separately the food without the soybean juice, and after that offering, he will take the food with the soybean juice.
But I said, but he doesn't offer that soybean juice, right?
Yes,
okay. So I'm saying he should offer it, and he should put it on a side dish. It should be there on a side dish.
Okay, sorry. 就是姑说，那您酱油你也得供奉，就是您把那个酱油放在食物里头，但是您可以单独做一个小盘子，然后在这个小盘子里放一点酱油，然后就让 Krishna 自己来决定他是不是这个酱油。
Everything we take, we should offer. Whatever goes in our mouth, you know, medicine, even you take medicine, you should offer it to Krishna.
无论我们吃什么，包括药物，我们要所吃的药也都要供奉。
Of course, sometimes we do a simple offering. We may just simply say, Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu, Sri Vishnu. That's a very simple offering.
有的时候我们是简单供奉，就是通我们念诵 Shri Vishnu, Shri Vishnu, Shri Vishnu, 简单的供奉。
But if you're preparing food and offering your food to Krishna, then you can put the soya on the side there and offer it also.
嗯，如果呢，您那个是在自己就是做饭供奉食物这时候呢，您就把那个酱油啊放在一个小碟子里头，然后呢。
And ask Krishna, tell Krishna, you can ask Krishna, Krishna, please, I'm sorry, I very much like to have soy sauce, so please kindly, if you can taste it also.
您就请求 Krishna, 哎呦 Krishna, 我特别喜欢酱油的味道，所以请您好心的也尝一下。Next question.
Yeah.
下一个问题是，应该还是 Krishna 吧，还是这个奉献者 ，Har Krishna Dinbai Gu。我觉得线下联谊如果没有读经典，就是浪费时间，没有住在 Krishna 直觉中。这样联谊我不想参与，请问 Guru 这样的心态正确吗？This devotee continue to ask that. Guru, I felt that.Human association with devotee in person, that I feel if there is no reading of scripture, it is a waste of time. It is not in Krishna consciousness. I do not want to participate in that in this association. So Guru, is this mentality right?
Yes.If it's the reading the scriptures, what? The reading scriptures, but it's not Krishna consciousness?
When this devotee is in the association with devotees and they do not read the scripture, they do not read.
Oh. So what? She doesn't want to associate with that devotee?
She didn't want to participate.
Well, you have to have some other association. You have to have some kind of association.
No. 那无论如何，您是要有某种联谊的。
Not everyone's able to read scriptures. Some people, but they like to chant.Some people like to do service. They may not read scriptures, but they do a lot of service. So you have to look at the over, you have to see, you know. I mean, you can't condemn someone just because they don't read. I mean, some people are illiterate. They're not able to read. And it's so difficult for them. How can they read?
不是每个人都倾向于读经典的，有的人倾向于念诵。有的人就是喜欢做服务，那还有的人呢，就是文盲，所以呢，我们不应当谴责别人，他们是文盲，有的人没办法读啊。
Yes, we should, you know, somebody doesn't read scriptures, but they like to chant Hare Krishna. There's, you know, they're devotees. They can do a lot of service. We have to be.You know, you have to be a bit more liberal. Don't reject people just for things like, you know, something like that.
就是有的奉献者就喜欢念诵 Hare Krishna， 还有的奉献者就做很多很多的服务。所以您就应当开明，思想开明，不应当拒绝这种事情。
So, to bring people to Krishna consciousness, it's a lot of work. And we have to show mercy and be kind to people and encourage them. And somebody is not reading scriptures, maybe you can read to them. Maybe they like to hear. Maybe there's some reason why they don't read scriptures. Maybe if you read the scriptures, they will listen.
所以要把一个人带到 Krishna 之间当中呢，是需要大量的工作的。所以您需要展示您的仁慈，您的好心，您需要鼓励别人。如果那个他们不读，您给他们读，也许他们喜欢听聆听，他们或者有种种原因，他们不读经典，不朗读经典。所以这时候您可以读，让他们听。下一个是，仆人。Hare Krishna, 你拜 Guru Dev 在崇拜 Tulsi 的时候，在供香的时候，是按照供灯的四二三七崇拜，这样可以吗？我只是看到的，不知道为什么，请教 Guru。 感恩您。 So, when we worship Tulsi, we also follow the rules that four rounds feet, two rounds the navel, three rounds worship to the face, and seven rounds. Is that all right?
Yes.
I don't know the ring.
Yeah, it's all right. If you like to do like that, you can do that. Okay.
Oh, 可以。你如果想要这样四二三七是可以的。
Yes.
He asked the reason why.
Why? Well, just to help us meditate on the different limbs of the body of Krishna.
那这个四二三七呢，就是为了来冥想 Krishna 的不同的身体的不同部位。
Oh, this is for Tulsi, worshipping Tulsi, huh?
Yes.
This all Tulsi is also the pure devotee.And the Tulsi tree is, you know, it's a holy tree, it's a sacred tree. And so we understand there's a personality there. And we offer to the root, because that's the lotus feet, like the lotus feet. And then we offer up, just like it's a person, you know, there's a person there within that form of the tree.
因为 Tulsi 是纯粹的奉献者，它是以圣树的形象显现的，所以要明白呢，在这个树的形象之内呢，它是有一个人格的。所以当我们供奉这个根部，这个供奉根部的时候呢，它就代表它的足，所以它是有人格的形象存在，就是于树的这个形象当中。
嗯。When we offer to the deity of Krishna, we offer like that. So when we offer to Prabhupada, we also offer like that. And when we offer to Tulsi, we also offer like that. Because Tulsi is a person, there's a personality there. And we're worshipping from the lotus feet, which is the root of the tree, and we worship up to the top. Hmm.
当我们崇拜神像，我们崇拜舍勒帕帕帕的，我们就是这样做的。那么 Tulsi 他也是一个人，也是有人格的，所以我们会崇拜他的莲花足，那就是他的树根，然后从树根部位再往上。
OK。
好 ，Yuvati Vishaka， 明白不？莲花足每次做服务都得达到奉爱，天天做饭。给 Krishna 唱诵，请问 Guru 内心对 Krishna 爱太少，怎么达到 Krishna 呢？So when we do devotional service, we should do it with love, bhakti. Every day we cook for Krishna, we chant. But Guru, I have few love for Krishna. How can we attain?Love, Krishna.
Well, you have to understand love means service. So when you're cooking, that is actual love.
爱就意味着服务，所以您做饭，那就是爱，实际上就是爱。
You don't just say, I love you. Love is not just sentimental. You know, like the young man and the young woman, they may say, oh, we're in love, and they may hug and kiss each other. You know, that kind of love, that is just sentimental. That is not real love. Real love means service.
我们看到就是年轻的男女他们可能会拥抱亲吻然后就彼此诉说衷肠说哎呀我太爱你了但是我们要明白爱可不是一个感情用事真正的爱就意味着服务。So
cooking for Krishna, that's a manifestation of your love for Krishna.
为 Krishna 做饭
You've already got the love of Krishna. Okay.
Okay. 先接受国家梵歌，还是先接受觉悟做的科学？其实我们在多数做服务，都是以自己的心意认为这样做那样做恰当，也根本无法确定是 Krishna 的意愿还是自己的心意，是吗？ Harini Maharaji said that, obeisance to Gurudev and all devotees, when we distribute books to the outsiders, should we first request them to accept the science of the Bhagavad Gita or the science of self-realization?
Well, you can let them choose. You can offer them and ask them which one do they want.
那您就把这选择权交给他们，问他们他们要什么。 She continued to ask that in most cases, we do service according to our mind. I think this is right and proper. We cannot be certain whether it is the will of Krishna or from our own mind. Is it true?
You should be guided by Sadhu Shastra and Guru. Yes, what you do should be under the directions of higher authority. The higher authority tells you should chant Hare Krishna, tells you should cook for Krishna, tells you should offer arti, like that.
更高等的指导呢，告诉您要唱诵 Hare Krishna, 为 Krishna 做饭，来供奉 arti.
If we just do things just according to the mind, you don't know if that's really what Krishna wants, so you should be guided by higher authority.
如果是仅仅出于心意做事儿，那就确实不知道到底是不是Krishna像，所以呢，就需要是更高等权威的指导。Yes,
that's a safe way, because you don't know.
这样,
you don't know if you're serving your mind or you're actually serving Krishna.
所以这是一个就是安全的方式。 因为你确实是不知道是来自于自己的心意还是来自于Krishna.
Okay, yeah.
Final one. Hare Krishna Guru, 我在崇拜有个疑惑，五圣体和六公三圈每个都绕拜。 This question is about offering, about the Panchatattva and six Goswamis. Should we?
Rao Bai, yes, circumambulate.
Okay. Shita Saki, ask that should we circumambulate Panchatadavan or Six Goswami together or separately?
Together.
Six rounds and
you can do them.
She continued. She added that it's not circumambulate, but offering incense or flower or ilan.
Well, usually when we put the pictures like that on the altar, we don't offer to each of these different things. We just put them there to show the disciplic succession. We don't have to offer the arti to all of these pictures.
We offer to the guru
and the guru's guru. And then we offer to Lord Chaitanya. Or if you have Lord Nityananda and then Lord Chaitanya. Yeah, Guru and Guru's Guru. And then Lord Nityananda and Lord Chaitanya. Like that. Okay.
Yeah, they say thank you.
Okay. So finished?
Yes, finished.
All right. So we thank Guru Mani, Matiji, Wama Ganshi Guru Mani, Kiwama Gentai Defani, Ganshi Soido Functions at LinkedIn and T1, Jufuniman, Shanghua Kwaila, Jui Shinti, Jinkan, Wisi Jinkan, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.